might be the best thing at this Festival of Holidays. Oh my god, y'all, you know when to give me that. Oh, when it gives you the dance out, like. Y'all, what's up? It's your girl Bri here with ET Magic. You know what time it is, okay? You saw by the title of this video, you know what time it is, y'all. One of my favorite times of the year, Festival of Holidays at DCA, y'all. And if you've been following this channel, you know, super emotional about this because last time I was here was when I couldn't even edit my vlog because I couldn't see. And I was very emotional leaving the parks. I tried my best for y'all. Nobody ever saw that footage because it was very sad to watch. I left crying because I was like, Mom, I don't even know if I'll be able to see the parks again. And now I'm back and I'm cute. But I'm back, okay? I'm gonna try not to cry. Came to eat the food, y'all. Make sure you just give this video a thumbs up. Like, I didn't even start yet, but give it a thumbs up because I made it back here and it's just a time to celebrate. Y'all already know my vision is not anywhere near perfect, but it's doable. And I'm here, Festival of Holidays, y'all. Let's go try some treats. I didn't bring my hot sauce in my bag, okay? I was too busy getting cute, but I'm gonna let y'all know what y'all need and what y'all need to skip, okay? Y'all ready? Let's go! Oh, you know what we came for? Pro tip, this line is so much more shorter than the one at Disneyland to get a picture in front of the tree. I know the trees are slightly different, but like if you just need a quick tree photo, come to DCA, y'all. All right, y'all, so we got it. It is $61, but with your annual pass holder discount, oh wait, Magic Key, it's 56, okay? So the first booth is somewhere here. I don't know which one it is, but we got it. I'm so excited, guys. Let's get started. Okay, so the first booth, right after you get your tab thingy, is favorite things, but all I want from there is the punch. So I'm gonna get that last. I really wanna get some food because they have the crispy adobo there, but we've gotten that every year. Right here is Making Spirits Bright, which I think is the one with all the drinks, and they have the queso. Yeah, they have the, oh no, they got Impossible Chicken Curry Bites. Okay, we're going here, y'all, we're going here.
All right, so this is here, and we got the Impossible Chicken Curry Bites with lemon raita and coriander chutney. This is also what they have. We may come back and get the tiramisu yule cocktail, but not now. All right, these are the Impossible Chicken Curry Bites with the lemon raita and the coriander chutney. It's $7.50. Let's give it a try. I'm gonna do this quickly because I think a parade is coming. I'm seeing cast members out here, y'all. But this is the Impossible Curry Chicken with lemon raita. And oh, it's kind of crispy, like chicken nuggets. That's what it is. Hold on. Coriander chutney. It's like a basic chicken nugget, but there is some spice to it. Absolutely delicious if you're trying to go no meat. Absolutely. I'm not really getting the flavor of the sauce. Hold on. Yeah, I can taste a little bit of the coriander. I don't know. It's good spice. If you're vegan, vegetarian, trying to do no meat, it is delicious. Now, it's spice, but I feel like these Impossible Chicken Nuggets, they have the same type of flavor anywhere you go. And this spice, this sauce on there is not hitting me anything special. Like the lemon, right, so I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. The coriander chutney, it's not hitting, it really just tastes like pesto and a light cream sauce. So, would I get it again? I don't know, it's my first dish. Let me see what else is delicious. Good spice, but not like a wow for me yet, okay? Well, let's go to the next booth. The parade is coming! We got a good spot, I hope it'll make us move.
Turkey leg.
You guys, look what they have here at the carts over by Avengers. They have the honey glaze.
Holidays turkey leg.
All right, so now we're going to a twist on tradition. They have a guava mango lassi, which we won. I think Diwali was just yesterday, the day before. It started, and then they also have a mac and cheese, a Krugel mac and cheese. So let's see if these are good.
Here's what they have here. Told y'all what we got. Let's see what's any good. Y'all, this is the guava. What is it? This is the guava melon lassi, and this is the savory Krugel mac and cheese with the sour cream. Let's get into it.
All right, y'all. So this is the savory Krugel mac and cheese. It was $8.50 from A Twist on Tradition. It has sour cream in there. It's topped with breadcrumbs. Let's see if it's any good. Oh, it's cool. What is Krugel? Are those the noodles? Or is that?
Probably.
Because the noodles don't look like elbow macaroni. And it doesn't look like kabatapi, which is my favorite. I do not like that. The crunch, the breadcrumb crunch on top is not seasoned at all. It just tastes like plain panko breadcrumbs with no kind of season in it. And the actual mac and cheese, there's a little hint of sweetness to it, but there's like no flavor. It's making me feel nauseous, actually. I think something with the sour cream too. It's creamy, but the flavor's not there. Oh, I should have did this booth last, because I feel like that with this guava melon lassi is gonna make me feel so sick. But let's try it. This was $7.50. Let's see if this is at least good. Okay, now that. This is fire. What does it taste like? Exactly what it says it'll taste like. It's a creamy and sweet. It's more of a guava flavor than a melon flavor. But it's really good. It's a sweet drink. It's creamy, but not too creamy. It's not as thick as other lassis that I've had. And then on top, there's like, it looks like cereal. What is this? Isn't that the cereal back in the day? On top? Y'all see it, right? Okay, that's on top. Let me see what the cream is giving. Yeah. Oh, this is really good. So I would absolutely recommend this. I would skip that mac and cheese. Let's go to another booth.
You guys, I need it. Oh my gosh. And it is Sherpa at the bottom. Oh, it's coming home with me. Coming over to this side, y'all. It looks like this is more of the merch. Oh, this is so cute. But this is a Magic Key exclusive. Magic Key exclusive. But I really need that. I really need the red one over there, y'all. Okay, let's go find some more food.
So I'm a little disturbed because mom did not like the lassi. She said it's not as thick as like it should be. And she said it was way too sweet. I did say it was sweet though. So I don't know, y'all. But we're going to go to some more booths. I'm seeing something right here. That merch was super cute. But I'm seeing some more stuff here. So let's see what booth is next.
All right, so this booth is Merry Mashups, y'all, and we are getting the Southern mac and cheese with the andouille sausage and the spiced panko crunch. I hope that's better than the mac and cheese that we just got. This is also what they have here, but we're just doing the mac and cheese. Ooh, this is the Southern mac and cheese. Let's get into it.
All right, y'all. The shadow is bothering me, but it's fine. We got the Southern mac and cheese with the andouille sausage and the spiced breadcrumbs. Let's see if it's any good. Okay, definitely like this one better than that first one we had. It still has a creamy consistency to the mac, but the actual mac and cheese is bland. What has flavor is the andouille sausage, and those spiced breadcrumbs are pretty good too. So would I recommend this? Yes, it has a little heat, it has a little saltiness. Mix it all up and eat it together. This is a good mac and cheese. We still have another mac and cheese, I think, at the festival to try. But as far as versus the other one, like don't even get the other one and be in my comments like, you told me, Bri. Like don't do it. This one is okay. Okay, see, the shadow is like, can you not? It's giving sabotage. There we go. this one is okay to get, okay? Now let's go try some more stuff in a different booth.
It's gonna be a special day. All my family friends and low and gather around to celebrate.
Let's
go! Shake a hand now. Merry Christmas!
Alright, so at the coffee shop right here by Little Mermaid, y'all, they have this, which you can get with one of the tabs. That's a little cold brew. I'm not gonna get it, but I just wanted to show you guys, okay? So let's go find some booze. Winter Sliderland is here. We're gonna get something from here. I know they have two sliders. Let me look and see which one I want. There's the beef brisket, but I think I want this Togarashi slider. Y'all, this is the Togarashi Karaj slider. I could be butchering that. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm sorry, but it has furikake. Now I know how to pronounce that. Mayo slaw on a Hawaiian roll. Let's try it. All right, y'all. So we got that slider with the slaw. I should have got a fork. Like, it's very messy. Very messy, but. I think out of the whole piece I just bit, I only finished 2.5 of it. Y'all, that's too much. It's way too much. As far as if we're talking flavor, there was some good flavor on the chicken part, the spice, but it was like, I don't know if that's how that chicken is supposed to be, but it's very like it's too chewy, too crunchy. I was almost choking. Like, it's a lot. I would not get that again. The slaw, I couldn't really tell the furikake flavor in there. I always put that rice seasoning on my rice, so I kind of feel like I know what it would taste like. Didn't get that in the slaw, and the slaw is so wet. So it reminds me of like a salad, you know, like leftover salad, like the next day, and it like is wilted and wet. It's not giving like a crunch, like just a light, you know, sauce on there. Like a piece of chicken just fell. I would not do this one. I would not do this one. I'm mad I didn't try the other slider. Let me see. I really don't want to get another tab just for one more slider. So let me try some other booths.
You shouldn't have ate that.
Like, huh?
You shouldn't have ate that. That's not good.
Like, I'm still choking from it. Like, it's not good. It's not good. It's not good. So, we're going to go to another booth to try something else. I should have got the other slider on here, but whatever. Let's see what else they have down yonder.
Y'all, I honestly can't get over how that chicken dish almost took my life. Like, I swear I almost choked like 4 times. I'm not even over exaggerating. Like, it was just thick pieces. You couldn't even bite into it to split it up. But here's another booth right here in front of Little Mermaid. Can't tell what it is yet, but I see some folks, a lot of people. What is this? Oh, Brews and Bites. Oh wait, this is where the queso fundido is. The queso fundido is right here at Brews and Bites. We're not gonna get that because we've gotten that in previous years. So let's see what else is all the way down by the jumping jellyfish. Y'all, I am confusion. I don't see any more booths. And we're over here by the Feliz Navidad area. I don't see no more booths, y'all. I know that's not it. That can't be it, because I still have more tabs and I planned out what I was gonna eat. So I'm lost. I'm gonna try to find a cast member and ask them. My mama's gone. I don't know where she at. But there's no booths over here, y'all. I'm so confused. All right, so the booths are hiding in Hollywoodland. So we're headed over there right now to try those. They do not come all the way down here like previous years. Although I'm starting to think to myself, remember I was out last year. Oops. I was out last year, so I don't know if they changed it. But I remember Food and Wine Festival used to come down here. That's what I was thinking. So let's just go see those booths over there. I did not know they were coming out, y'all. I was just walking to Hollywood Studios.
All right, so as soon as you come in to the left, after I got my thing, right here is Favorite Things. And they have the braised pork belly adobo, which is always amazing with the garlic rice. I already know how that is. I've had it every year I've been here. But this time we got this cherry mango punch. I want to see what that's like. And they also have this year, I'll probably get this next time. That cold brew looks good. And then they have this macaron to celebrate the Santa Claus show.
All right, we're on a mission. We're on a mission. Mom is tired. I'm ready to go. And the other booths to buy Monsters, Inc. So we're going to walk and talk with this.
Oh, it's really good, though.
Woo! It has a strong mango flavor. There's a frozen peach on top. I don't think the peach is that frozen, though, but this is a nice punch. This is thick. Now, this is how thick the lassi should have been. Okay? This is a thick drink, so if you don't like thick, don't get it. It's not overly sweet, but there is a strong mango nectar flavor in this. I like that a lot, y'all, so I would get this punch again, but it is a little thick. Okay, so now we're gonna find the last booth and be out of here.
Y'all, don't forget, Festival of Holidays is also about all kind of other markets. This place has like some sweet treats here. There have been a ton that I found walking along the way, but I didn't vlog it because I was on a mission just to get to the booths, okay, y'all? And it looks like this is the booth. Oh, there's two more booths here. Oh, yes, we made it, y'all. All right, so we're at Holiday Duets. We made it. And I got the... Wait, I did not get that. Wait. Hey, y'all can order both from here. I got super confused. That's why I was like, that's not what we got. But I ended up getting the mac and cheese here. So let's try that. This is what else they have here at Holiday Duets. Y'all, this is the carnitas mac and cheese. Ooh, ooh. Let's get into this.
All right, from Holiday Duets, we got this mac and cheese, y'all. Let's get into it, the carnitas mac and cheese. You know what? The carnitas has flavor. I don't think I like these little crunchies. The puff rice. I forgot the flavor that they said it is, but you know what? It's a good mac and cheese. If I had to rate all the mac and cheese, I would say the southern one first, this one second, the last one, the Kugel, don't even get it. Like, it's not even rated. When I made the trek back here to get this, I don't think so. I think I would stick with the southern mac and cheese one, but it's not bad. It's still a creamy one. And the carnitas tastes good. It's the puff rice that's throwing me off, okay? The carnitas tastes good, the mac and cheese tastes good. It's just that puff rice. It's something about that flavor I'm not feeling, okay? You know, it actually kind of tastes a little bit like a... Yeah. Something is... I can't figure it out, okay? Maybe it's something done here, okay? We got one more treat to try. I'm just saying this ain't my favorite, okay? Let's go to the Grandma's Recipe booth.
All right, Grandma's Recipes, y'all. We got the tamale. But this is what else they have here. But we got the tamale. Oh, wow. Look at this. It looks so good, y'all. Let's get into it. Friends, we made it to the finish line. Got the tamale. Barbacoa tamale. Let's get into it. There's some kind of verde salsa. I forgot what it's called over there, but it's a green salsa. On top, some kind of crema.
Oh my gosh. Oh, y'all, it was worth coming over here. I almost gave up. When I didn't see any booths by the jellyfish, I was like, I'm done. Even though I had some more tabs. But y'all, this might be the best thing at this Festival of Holidays. Oh my god, y'all, you know when they give me that, when it gives you the dance out, like, it's moist, the meat on the inside is flavorful, there's a spices to it, the green salsa is delicious, I swear, I would literally take this thing next time and just get 8 of these, like, it's giving everything the Festival of Holidays should give, okay? This is a winner. I'm so happy I came over here. Start your day off with this. Like, get this. And if you're out of tabs because you went to all the other places, like, buy it. Like,
this is where it's at. Okay, who was that? Grandmama's, what was it called? It's called Grandma's Recipes. And somebody's Apolita did the thing, okay? Somebody did the thing. That's it for Festival Holidays, you guys. Thank you so much for hanging with me for this part two. Honestly, I can't even remember what, I mean, I remember liking the southern mac and cheese a little bit. I remember the vegan thing in the first vlog was okay, but this is knocking it out the park. So even if you don't want to get a tab thing, get one of these. Remember, this is $61 with your annual pass holder, but magic key holder discount is $56. You get 8 tabs, y'all. Remember, there's also a bunch of other stuff going on at the festival. It's not just the booths, but this is a winner, okay? Make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Because you know we're doing some, you know we're doing more holiday treats, right? In Disneyland and DCA, like outside of the Festival of the Holidays. So make sure y'all follow along, okay? I'll see y'all next time. Bye!
Okay, y'all, we got some performers.
Love and joy come to you, and to you by Christmas too, and we wish you and say